Water. It covers nearly two-thirds of the planet. It changed a barren rock into a thriving oasis of life. Water is so rich that all terrestrial life relies on only 1/10,000th of the planet's supply. It seems that water is an endless natural resource, but it is not. Humans are changing the environment so much that a 4.5 billion year old natural recycling program is beginning to fail. Take, for example, Haiti, an island in the Caribbean. 90% of its forest has been cleared. Flash floods have led to soil erosion, leading to the destruction of nearly all of its fertile farmland. Its freshwater reserves and lakes are shrinking, and its coastal seabeds are being smothered by runoff from the mountains. Its rivers are dry and filled with silt. Haiti, once a lush paradise, is now one of the driest, most disease-ridden places on Earth. Around the world, signs of man's greed are glaring reminders of how important water is. Yet our ongoing interference with nature threatens our greatest resource. Palau has one of the most biologically diverse marine environments in the world. Palau's forests are home to an impressive diversity of flora and fauna, including at least 23 varieties of orchids found nowhere else in the world. The health of these ecosystems relies on a delicate balance from ridge to reef. The fate of Haiti seems impossible in Palau, but that is what the Haitians also once thought. Palau's great biodiversity is supported by bubbledaw streams, rivers, and mangrove forests. These key areas rely on a flow of water, which if disrupted, can destroy habitats very, very quickly. Sadly, throughout Palau there is already visible evidence of ecosystem damage. Reckless destruction of Palau's upland forests and wetland areas, including taro patches and mangrove forests, are beginning to show signs of major damage. While all of Palau's land is important, there is one area which, like water itself, allows life to thrive. Our watersheds. A watershed is a land area in which falling rain is eventually guided to a single point, a river mouth, a bay, or a sea. Once rain falls on the earth, it either evaporates to fall again, flows through soils and bedrock to settle as groundwater, or flows across the surface of the land and through streams and rivers to meet the ocean. This journey of liquid can have powerful effects, carving the landscape, carrying soil and nutrients across the island. Guided and filtered by vegetation, this flow is the lifeblood of Palau. This mass of moving liquid can also carry pollutants, poisons, and sediment to places never intended, with devastating consequences. As areas become more developed, natural areas are replaced by surfaces that water cannot flow through. Pavement, cement, roads, or rooftops. This tampering with nature's balance can result in loss of habitats, stream bank erosion, soil degradation, a decrease in agricultural productivity, reduced quantity of water available for drinking and other uses, and increased water pollution in our rivers, bays, and the ocean. Babeldaob, the largest island in Palau, is our main source of food, fresh water, and ecological stability, and produces 500 million gallons of fresh water every day. The three largest watersheds, Ngardort, Ngarmudu, and Ngarigil, produce half of this water discharge. The Ngarmudu watershed is approximately four times the size of Koror State. It is Palau's largest watershed, crossing three states, Imelig, Ngatpang, and Ngarmulungui. Three major rivers run through the Ngarmudu watershed, which empties into Ngarmudu Bay, one of Palau's important marine nursery grounds. The bay is one of the most biologically diverse marine areas in the world. The second largest watershed, the Ngardor watershed, is located in Esar and Malkayok states. It includes Lake Ngardok, Micronesia's largest natural freshwater lake, and the rest of the Ngardor River. The Ngardok Nature Reserve protects the watershed area, draining into Ngardok Lake, which feeds the water source for Malkayok's residential area and the future capital. In southern Babeldaob's Airai State, the Ngarigil watershed covers an area of 11 square miles, making it Palau's third largest watershed. This watershed supplies the drinking water for Airai State and the city of Koror, approximately 75% of our population. Each watershed has three distinct zones. The upper zone on mountain and hilltops has healthy natural forest and deeply cut tributaries. The lower elevated middle zone consists of river floodplains where the vast majority of development is occurring. The lower zone contains mangrove forest at sea level, making it the nursery for many of Palau's marine creatures. Through thousands of years of Palauans occupying Babeldaob, the watershed areas were largely undisturbed. However, in the last 30 years, major changes to the land have occurred. There has been extensive land clearing for agricultural purposes, and much of the mangroves and forested buffer zones along the banks of the Ngarigil have been destroyed. There have been major construction projects, such as the National Airport and Compact Road, as well as various residential and commercial developments, all affecting our vital watershed. Airai Bay is an important fishing area.
My dear Wamran, the Mangrang, Namodia, and Mosa, or indeed it, Mundia, I get kicking.
His bedroom, Lia, and a mood I get a wa. As a show by Nara, I got Tigalum, Rula was show by. Remood I get him, get killed with a couple of Matangrata. My galley was a metam, Remood I get the gum and Dagalbil. Galwako, Mr. Ba, my galley was his. Leng Sumundiak. Engal mutel sel ay marake marong sel opteng ara karge den du lokwa ta patan ngiro kelem takas el dupo arulo ya omo ara ka dia ka ngaral tamaldi ara ala di tobul du dar tu fit tobutra isera itera almol el mutel gri ge mo mutel mbe aral ma tob de marong ngi amaral mokol do ra partak
As a result of unplanned development, large amounts of sediment are flowing into the river and the bay, killing off corals and seagrass. These sensitive areas around Babeldaob and Palau are also stressed due to a steady increase in the number of gasoline fuel speedboats, increased diving, overfishing, foreign fishing vessels, and the growth in Palau's tourism and population, all of which is affecting the abundance and diversity of marine and terrestrial life in Palau. Palau's national and state governments, along with local conservation agencies, convened in March of 2003 to determine how best to protect the Ngarigil watershed. They concluded that the most pressing concern was the sediment-laden runoff reaching the river and ultimately the ocean. Sediment-laden runoff can be traced to unpaved roads and construction sites, as well as erosion from agriculture practices, burned savanna areas, and the stream bank. Palau's fragile soils took hundreds of thousands of years to develop, and once disturbed, will be nearly impossible to re-establish. Unpaved roads in the watershed are the primary source of erosion, creating 100 times more soil loss than plants can withstand. Paving would reduce erosion to virtually nothing. Construction sites quickly create large areas of fast erosion. Simple soil conservation methods, like using mulch and other types of soil cover, can reduce erosion by 85% at these sites. Strict environmental laws must be enacted that call for road paving and construction site conservation methods. An assessment of the area also studied erosion from agriculture and determined that if areas are farmed using the traditional Palauan method of agroforestry, soil erosion would be within an acceptable range.
Say the time ra kin ko tum no sir sa say malum sin the clear aran di el alba alba tok la do sir sum umru ral mal ol tal mal la ral di til gi bul ul ndi mo kar kar da ro ki sir ral mang ri ki sir sa di akbol ngod bai di ral ma mo ngod emer ko ya sir sa di kat mel di kel wet land gi mo spen sel ai ge am lam tamal ra utum tuk matmal ra ut mai kal ba ra ra lo la ba ut ma bertak lo la ben men teng ra ke luet land ki mo msel ai ke gi dam la mo mu ra ut
Only a generation ago, subsistence farming was practiced throughout Palau. This traditional method minimizes the disturbance of the soil and maximizes the input of organic matter by intermixing crops, plants, and shrubs in small patches. In contrast, poor farming practices, such as tilling the soil and leaving bare areas unvegetated, detach large amounts of soil. This soil is eventually carried as runoff into streams, bays, and onto the reefs. In fact, with the heavy rainfall in Irai State, tilling soil on any slope and leaving it bare for even short periods will lead to significant erosion. Burning to clear land in the savanna or grasslands is another major problem. This burning removes the vegetation and produces ash, which is typically washed away by heavy rains, causing a loss of nutrients in the soil. Soil erosion from burned savannas is almost 100 times the erosion rate of unburned grasslands. Failing stream banks also create sediment. While some of these are naturally occurring, human-induced stream bank erosion is also present. Along the Ngarigil River bank, land is being tilled for agricultural purposes, which has removed the natural forest and plant buffer next to the stream. The roots of native plants in these buffer zones hold the bank together, protecting it from slippage and erosion. Removal of these buffer areas leaves the riverbanks vulnerable to erosion. A riparian zone of between 35 and 65 feet should be maintained along the banks of the river and all tributaries in the watershed in order to minimize stream bank erosion. Trees should be planted in bare areas. Finally, we must minimize the use of pollutants. Consider the impact of direct discharges from gasoline stations, automobile oils and laundry facilities that discharge phosphates and bleach from washing. Animal manure, excess fertilizers and pesticides are specific agricultural concerns. Excess nutrients, particularly nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, contained in fertilizer and animal manure are toxic to aquatic wildlife and can be a major human health hazard. Development of a nutrient management plan for animal manure and proper application of fertilizers are critical. Dangerous pesticides and herbicides have devastating effects on soil fertility, water quality, and natural habitats. A waste management plan, such as waste reduction, recycling, and composting, must be implemented.
We required buffer zones around all of the mangroves and all of the streams. And if you look at studies that have been done of sediment, or even what we call non-point source pollution, pollution that might come off of farm fields, that might be chemicals, it might just be sediment. If you run that into a vegetated buffer, it drops to zero in a matter of 25 to 50 feet. Depending upon the slopes. If you got a shallow slope, you don't need as much vegetation. If you have a steep slope where the water's moving faster, you need a wider band. But one of the things that Iowa State and some of the other states along the compact road might want to start thinking about is if this road is going to open up the kind of development that Palau has sort of wanted for itself, better start thinking about your water, better start thinking about how close you want land clearing to get to the vegetation around streams and around the embayments, because it's going to feed down into the water supplies.
In group, here la selinga dikil watershed protection program. Yo mralo mesa yi del vasiorti al compact road el la mombre. The one you get the longer it was in soft soil areas, you get the longer it was in blow oil moringa problem ringileng sel lu utama dam dam na mata tul magaya la la primer pa pember ko e melgat ringil mol 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 mo si si leng te dire ko lo uspe agel gay sel mesho e wa mesra kisi la era gol lo melar sel final way dri ya sul time ngay idle tabia kamra IPM le mencion lo hacen mal importante la pelgula y el lo hacen buffer strip maluben y el buffer zone el mamaradra es el aire y working group para ngrigil watershed a la morir om suverni magi y trail implementar ni de lang este alurro a ti me lo molma ma el tu magi ulpen tri tri garada el me prop del meu mesa allà a mosso va amb el i vora device a plans, a long term plans el mosso ve el take care té el l'ur de molt volver té el i la il·lum real me la dirigui el watershed ja estarà clou el mat clau el gul i aquí del el buffer zone el també té una buffer zone som el mosso ve el clinar al mirar del clau del vora ila ilum ran kuang rimel
itu alam bila hal me tengah dia ada ini ada CCD
ngari ngai gitu lah dra IPA ngai gitu black pensioner ngil tam yokam nge wetland expert mengele mai polina nge adra fish and wildlife ba kemamel adra area state working group di legislator sama Governor. Si quiere ahora a teletele te arruera, mete a dime el molman. Y mouro en el device a teletele ahora a doctor plan el quiere la dirigir ahora si el.
Palau is beginning to understand the need for conservation and is making serious efforts to avoid a future similar to that of Haiti. Palauan chiefs still institute the age-old traditional conservation system of moratorium, called bull, during times of scarcity until those resources become re-established. Several states have merged traditional and modern laws to strengthen their conservation efforts. Today, there are at least 21 conservation areas, all created by state laws. While most conservation areas are for the protection of marine resources, several have been designated to preserve watersheds, mangroves and upland forests, including Lake Nerdok and SR's Musaglat River watershed. In November 2003, President Remongsau signed the Protected Areas Network Act. This PAN Act provides the mechanism for the national government to provide technical and financial support to state-owned and state-managed conservation areas. It also can facilitate cooperation among the states where important areas of biodiversity cross state boundaries. Development is inevitable and necessary for Palau's growth as a nation. However, we are entrusted to manage this development. The future of Babeldaob, of Palau, of our water, is in our hands. We will be the ones to decide what the Palau of the future will look like. We will decide the fate of our island and our children. If we want to preserve the Palau of today, we must plan for tomorrow.
This video has been made possible through a partnership of iRice State, the USDA NRCS, and PCS. For more information on simple ways you can protect your watershed, please contact the following.